Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. In this video, we will learn how to navigate through our online library to find the exact robot you're looking for. We will then learn how to import it in your RoboDK station so that you can use it in your project. Let's get started. So here's the station we tried to mimic. We need to create another one from scratch. So let's press Ctrl and N to create a new station. File, new station would have also worked. Okay. Starting from here, you have two options to reach our online library. Either you can open a web browser and go to robodk.com. You can then go to resources and then supported robot. And in under supported robot, you will find our library. So that's how to reach it from the internet. Now, if you are in RoboDK, you can press on the globe here to launch the online library. If you do so, RoboDK will either have one of two different behavior. So either it will open the library just here beside the RoboDK station tree. It will be the embedded version, so that works. Or it will open directly in the web browser. I personally prefer this method. The difference between one behavior or the other will be dictated by what's happening under tools option, and then other. Here you have a checkbox for open on a browser. So if this one is checked, obviously it will open in a browser the same way it's doing right now. Okay, so RoboDK's library count over 600 different industrial robots. So there's a lot of robots from a lot of different companies, over 30 different brands. So most likely you should find the robot you're looking for. If it's not the case, if you own a RoboDK professional license, you can simply contact us. We'll be happy to help you add the robot to our library, generally within a few business days. You just need to have the 3D models and manuals of the robot. If you don't own a RoboDK professional license, you can still create the robot yourself. We have a series of 3 or 4 videos on our YouTube channel that will describe you or explain you step by step how you can create a new robot by just using the 3D model and user manual of that given robot. So that's an option. As we have a lot of robots and a lot of brands, we had to add some kind of filter to our robot library so that you can easily find a specific robot model. So here, if we were just to look at ABB, we have over 100 different model of ABB robot. So that's kind of a bit complicated to scroll through. So instead you can go here for brand and then filter for a given brand. In our case, we're looking for a Fanuc CR series. So I can go here and select Fanuc, or I can simply enter Fanuc here in the filter and select the right filter. So just like that here, you can see the robot we're looking for. So the Fanuc CR7IAL. So I can click download and I can simply drag and drop it to my RoboDK station. So it was imported right here. As you can see, the station origin matches with the physical base of the robot. In the case of a Fanuc robot, the actual programmatic base is here, right where joint 1 and joint 2 cross. So here, this is a small difference between some different brands where the base is not necessarily where the physical base of the robot is. Okay, so when we have a robot, we could play with it. So if I double click on it, it will move exactly the same way as the one we had in the previous example in module 1. So let's add a tool to that. So if I go to the online library, I can click here, reset filter. And if you go under type, you will see that we have different types of filter that you can apply. So either you can search for 5 degrees of freedom, 6 degrees of freedom, 7 degrees, cameras. If we have cell, full station, you have delta robots, grippers, inspection tools, some objects. We'll go back at this one later. palletizing SCARA tool. So, and this is the one we'll be selecting for now. So we have a bunch of tools that you can quickly add to your RoboDK station. We are fully aware that most RoboDK, most station, robotic station, in fact, will be using custom tooling. So we have the flexibility to create custom tool. I will show you how to do that in two or three videos, if I'm not mistaken. But we also give you the opportunity to create station and simulation very quickly by using one of the previously created tool. So what you can do is simply here, does it say that we're looking for a weld torch? So let's say this one, we can simply click download and we can drag and drop it to our station, and it will automatically attach itself to our robot, as RoboDK knows that it's a tool. So like that, perfect. So I can hide the robot flange, and just like this, I can move from the robot TCP. I can press minus a few times to reduce the size of my targets. Let's say here it could be cool to add a table underneath the robot to just add a bit more realisticness to our station. So under type, you have object, and in object we have different stuff. We have conveyors, basic fencing, bigger table, pedestal. We have a small table here that I'll be using. So let's click download and drag and drop it here in our station. So by default, all objects are uploaded at the root of the station, or where the origin of the station is. So right here, 000. So that's perfect. Later, we can, I'm going to show you, in fact, in the next video, how you can move objects around to position them exactly where they should be with respect to your real station. So that's important if you want to do, be able to do real programming, real collision detection, and so on. We need to have a virtual station that match as closely as possible the real station we have. So that's one thing. Okay, and then last thing, I'm gonna download a simple cube here as an object. So if I bring that cube here, you can see here it appeared in my station tree. Here you have table and then you have box, but you don't see it. It's because it was imported at the root of the station, so at the origin of the station. So it was simply hidden behind the robot like that here. So what I can do, I can either move it around, but I'm gonna show you how to do that in the next video, or I can create a frame here that I can bring in front of it. I can name that frame, I don't know, press F2 and name that frame part, and I can move that box here. And then the box is right in the middle of the frame part. So just like that, I can hide the frame and let's bring back the frame and just move this object a little further here. And I could go ahead and click program, teach target on surface, just select snap on corner. And then I can come here, create one target, create another target, and then press minus a few times here, create a fourth target. Just like that, I can create a program, control C and then control V, and then I can change that for linear motion. And just like that, I have a small program that follows the edges of that cube or that box. As simple as that. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to properly position objects in a station, how the position of an object actually works. We have to talk about object's origin, object relative position, frames, and a few things like that. So that will be very interesting and especially very important if you want to have a station that does match, and easily, in fact, have a station that do match with your real station. Okay. In any case, I hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.